produce two sensors. One is the temperature sensor and second one is the gas sensor. Temperature sensor and gas sensor. Third practical we are going to perform fluid sink, then temperature and gas. Then after that we are going to perform the practical of components of pneumatic system, which is available in unit number 4. And lastly we are going to measure the water flow measurements by using the sensor. The important sensor is the holometric sensor, which is used to measure the flow of water which is flowing through this tap. This is the simple assembly I have done for the practical. One tank, this is the tube. Then I have provided here one manual valve, open closed valve. Then I have connected one sensor, which is called as a water flow sensor. It is also called as a holometric sensor. The specification of this sensor is already given. And you can collect the water flow from this. So all are the simple practicals, only you have to concentrate how to do the connections. So first of all, we are going to do the practical interfacing of any two sensor with the Arduino. Control input pins. What is the Arduino board which access it, which control input? Add mega. Interfacing of any two sensor with DA2. It is written on the top. I am going to provide the introduction of the UPP. This kit is the interfacing of two sensor with data acquisition. What is my data acquisition? We have to acquire the data. This is the simple kit which is designed. This one is the Arduino board. Then this is the clone of the Arduino. Whatever the practical which can perform by this Arduino board, the same practical can be performed by it. Okay. Then what is the necessity of this? Because if any problem occurs in the Arduino or if any problem occurs in the clone, we can do the program on Arduino. Then I have connected here one simple breadboard. What is the necessity of that breadboard? Because I have given the name of this board as a mechatronic development board. By using a single board, you can develop the number of practicals. So that's why I have provided you with some breadboard and one in the display, which is for the displaying the output values. Okay. So you can also do the connection from Arduino to display, or you can connect. You can also see the output from the serial monitor. But here we are going to see the outputs of every practical on serial monitor rather than seeing the output on display. Why? Because for doing the connections of display, you need to do the connection, the 6-7 connection will be used. So you are from the first batch and the days are remaining, very few days are remaining. So all the outputs we are going to see on the serial monitor. So first practical is interfacing of any two sensor. The two sensors are the temperature sensor and gas sensor. First of all, we are going to connect the temperature sensor. Arduino board we are going to use. Just open the Arduino software. After opening the Arduino software, you will get one unit. This is the programming window. This is the programming of Arduino software. The program is already written for the Arduino or for your practical. Now, DHT11, you will require a DHT11 library file. You have to add the DHT11 library file to perform the practical of temperature sensor. Then we have connected DHT and TM7. Yesterday I have told you the connections. How many terminals it is having? 3 terminals. What are the terminals? Plus 5 volts, ground, and output, which is taken from the temperature sensor. Now temperature sensor is nothing but the analog type of sensor, because temperature is continuously going to be changed. So this is the HT11 analog type of sensor. Now this IC is connected, the analog will be converted into digital, and you are going to connect that digital pin to the pin numbers 7. HT11 is the name of sensor. dealing with the name of sensor, which is nothing but temperature sensor module. And the output of the this sensor, we are going to connect the pin numbers in the Arduino board. It is also given over here, positive, negative, and the output of the sensor is connected to the pin number 7. So by seeing this connection also, see this number and your programming number should be matched. If you have provided here number 8, it will not work. Because in programming we have provided 7, here we are going to do the connection at 8, so it will show you some error. So, what? How to do the practicals? Simple practicals. First pin is ground, second pin is data, means digital, and third one is VCC. Just you have to mount these three terminals on the breadboard. You will require three wires, one is positive, one is negative, and third one is output. The first terminal is a ground terminal, you have to connect that ground to the ground terminal. This one is the ground, you have to connect that ground to the ground terminal of Arduino. Everything is given here. Ground, VCC, digital, D1, D2, A0, A1, A2, everything is here. You have to only do the connection. Then second one is the positive. Just connect the positive to the positive plus 5 volt of the Arduino board. So it is the plus 5 volt of the Arduino board. Before going to that, you have to do the connection from Arduino to laptop. How to do the connections? How to do the connection? Just connect cable, data cable, the Arduino board, and with the laptop. Now we have provided a 5 volt supply, so LED will be on. Now our one terminal is which is necessary, which is remaining. What is output terminal of the HT11? Just connect the output terminal, which is nothing but which is and the output terminal is connected to the pin number 7 of the Arduino board. So just connect it to the pin number 7. Okay, the connections are over. While after connecting the cable to every Arduino board, just select tools and cross check the two connections. First of all, whether it is connected to Arduino Uno or not. Lot of types of Arduino boards are available. You have to select here Arduino Uno, it is default, it is selected. And second one is port, to which port you have connected the COM cable. So right now COM cable is connected to port number 19, but you have not selected. So you have to connect that COM port here. Now it is okay. So these two connections you have to cross check. Now after doing this connection, first of all you have to compile the program, and second thing you have to upload the program. Compilation means what? You are going to check the error in the program, whether it is, any error is available or not. So there is a right click, just click on that, your program will be compiled. So now compilation is going on. Once it will get over, it will show you the compilation is over. Okay, done compiling. And what is next step? We have to upload the program from Lapido Arduino board at Mega 328 IC, controller IC. So just upload that one. Now compilation is over. Now it is going for the upload. Uploading is showing the uploading. Done uploading means now program is
done.
We have uploaded the program. Now what we have to see? We have to see the output. I have told you we can see the output by two ways. We can see the output on display. We can see the output on computer also. Now in computer we are having the serial monitor with. We are having the serial monitor window. Just click on the serial monitor window. It is available at the right side top. So just click on that one, it will show you the serial monitor. Just click on that one, it will show you the output. So it is showing you the temperature 25, it is showing you the humidity 70. And this is your output. How you are going to change this output? Just change the temperature, so that I am going to put this one. So my body temperature will be changed by this one. Suppose it will be changing. Now from 70 it comes to the 71. From 25 it comes to the 26. Again I am going to change this one. So it will come 85, 82, 27, 81, 79. So it is going to set the temperature and humidity. Now suppose again you will require the output very strong. Means suppose you have to plot the graph. Sir ने बताया 22 ग्रिड लेना है, ग्राफ बताना है, यार कौन करेगा? X axis निकाल लो, Y axis ग्राफ पे कर लो. Doesn't need that one. Just cross this one. Go to the tools and there will be the serial plotter. It will plot the humidity and temperature which is available. If you want to change the humidity and temperature, see you will get the peaks here. Now it will be down, 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 and it will come to the bottom. So this is called as a graph. It's called as a graph. So just take this graph, just take the reading, take a snapshot, and put it into the result. This will be the result. Yes. Are you getting my point?
Yes.
So this will be the simple rectangle of temperature and humidity measurement. What will be our second sensor? Yes. Now yes, the question might be asked, this is the data acquisition, how you are going to acquire the data? Simple. So for acquiring the data, you will require Eagle software. Then you have to do the connection from Eagle to your XP or Windows 7. Then that Eagle software will create the .csv file, and then you can acquire the data. But suppose you want to data from last 5 minutes only, you can take the snapshot and you can take the print. So it is also the acquiring of data. Acquiring is storage of data.
Storage.
So second practical is just remove that one. What will be your second sensor?
Gas.
Yes.
The second sensor will be a gas. The second sensor will be a
gas
sensor. How the there will be a gas sensor? It looks like this. Gas sensor is having the number of types. Means sensor is MQ6, MQ7, MQ8, MQ5. The LPG gas is MQ5. You are here. MQ5. Why MQ5 is used? To detect the gas.
Yes.
To detect the LPG gas. Why MQ6 is used? To detect the alcohol. Why MQ7 is used? To detect the smoke. So the fabrication is same, module is also same, only some minor changes in the name which is available inside. Some circuit is changed so that it will detect the alcohol, it will detect the smoke, it will detect the gas. So it is totally depend upon the intensity of the particles which is available in the gas, which is available in the smoke, which is available in the alcohol. Now again it is having the three terminals. The terminals are, what is the output of gas sensor? It will be the analog one. So we have to define the analog port. Just go to the gas, click on that. The window will be open. Gas sensor we have connected at integer sensor A0. Kaun se pin ko connect kiya hai?
Gas analog.
A0 means analog port. So white connector here where they have given A0, D0, PCC ground. So output is A0. I am going to connect at A0 plus 5 volt. I am going to connect at plus 5 volt and ground. I am going to connect at the ground. Gas sensor. Again, upload the program. As it is, I know this is the this program don't have any error. Directly I am going to upload. So whenever you are going to click at the upload, first of all, again it will clean the compile. It will go for the compilation and then it will go for the uploading. So it will go into the run uploading. Then go to the serial monitor window. It will show you the previous value which is detected by this. क्यों? क्योंकि मैंने इसके ऊपर स्प्रे मारा है, तो वो जल्दी जाएगा नहीं. Dust particle उसने कैच कर लिए नेट में. So what will happen? Again it will be increasing. Now I am going to again increase this one. 131, 130. See that. 209, 190, 180, 160. In the output, 200, 170, 175. Instead of that, you are going to plot this one by using a plotter. Just go to the tool and plotter. It will show you the continuity variation. Okay? So it is going to detect the gas.
Yes.
Which will be detected by the gas sensor, and we can plot that outputs on a plotter also, or we can say it is not digital, it is analog, continuously varying in nature. So in this way, this is the simple practical for
yes.
Interfacing of any two sensor with Arduino board, or we are going to acquire it by taking the snapshot of your window.